Hello students, welcome to my physics channel. In this video I am going to discuss about projectile motion numerical students. I mean horizontal projectile numericals. So we can consider this as a horizontal projectile numerical part. Okay, so students, one by one we will discuss here. So what are the formulas to be noticed here? The first formula, write down the time of the total time of flight. Actually what happens in the horizontal projectile, students, once again I'll give you the review. So actually this is a ball we are going to throw horizontally, so it will come like this. Yes or no? So once it is reaching the ground, we know this is horizontal range, which is denoted by R. This is already we know, this is h, students, maximum height from where the object has projected, that is called as h here. Let me consider the time taken for the object to reach the ground as t. Already I told you the formulas, list of formulas, write down. The total time taken is given by 2h by g under root. You can see my previous video. Based on this horizontal projectile motion, you will be having this kind of formulas, okay. This is the first formula, and the second formula is, you know very well students, the initial velocity, I mean to say horizontal velocity is always constant. That thing you know very well. And coming to the range is equals to, write down students, this horizontal range is equals to u into velocity, horizontal velocity into time of flight. So total time taken. So this is one of the formula. And v velocity vector at any time t is given by, what is the formula? So vx I cap plus vj j cap. So vx I cap plus vy j cap, students. So this is nothing but vx is always u. You can see here vx is always u here, horizontal component. U I cap minus gt j cap, students. Why minus here is, it is coming downwards now, that's why minus we have to consider, students. So these are the very important formulas. So now if at all this vector form actually this is vector form actually. So if at all you want the magnitude of this velocity at any time t, then the formula is given by v at any time t is given by u square plus g square t square, students. So based on this we can do any problem, students. So one by one we will discuss what are the problems will comes under this, okay. Shall we start the numerical part? Yes, students. Make a note of this all formulas so that it will be helpful for you. Once you can see the horizontal projectile video, then you can come to this, then definitely you can understand lot of things here. Okay, as a first problem, write down, students. First problem, write down. The velocity of a projectile, write down, a body is projected horizontally from a height is given by, I'll write here, students, h is equals to 78.4 meters, students. Okay, after that, with a velocity u is equals to, write down, the velocity u is equals to 10 meter by second. After 3 seconds, what is that? So what they are asking is velocity after 3 seconds. Velocity after 3 seconds. First of all, you should know what they are asking. So they are asking in vector form. So vector form means, you know very well, velocity vector at any time t is equals to u I cap minus g t j cap. Students, do not forget this. U means horizontal component of velocity, everywhere u only. Gt in a sense, based on the time period it will changes, okay, you know very well. So v bar at any time t is given by u means what already we know, that is 10 I cap, write it down, minus g means what, 10 itself, t means what, you know what is the time here, 3 seconds they told us, so 3 seconds j cap you can write here. Can you tell me what is the final answer here? V bar is equals to 10 I cap minus 30 j cap will be the answer for that. If at all you want magnitude means, you can find magnitude. How can you find? 10 square plus 3 square under root. So this is how we are finding the magnitude, but they asked in vector form. So answer is 10 I cap minus 30 j cap, students. I hope you understand. Shall we go for next problem?
Yeah.
Make a note of this. Students, you can get this questions on the screen. You can copy that. Okay, fine. In above problem, in the same problem, students, in the above problem, in the previous problem, so angle made by the velocity vector, right? No? What is the angle made by velocity vector to x axis? That is what they are asking in the second problem. Let me consider, what is the formula I told you clearly? Tan theta is equals to y component of velocity by x component of velocity. This formula, do not forget this, where theta is an angle made with respect to horizontal, students. I told you in the video itself, you can see that. So uy, vy in a sense, what? Vertical component of velocity at time t. Already they have given the previous problem. 3 seconds, right? 3 seconds, right? So that's why. So 3 seconds in a sense, what do you mean by 3 seconds? You can substitute here. So vy in a sense gt at any time t, gt, vertical component of velocity, and horizontal component is u only. So gt in a sense, already we know 30 by 3. So this cancel. Finally, we will be getting, so u is 10, already given, no, in the problem itself. So 3. So tan theta is equal to 3. Then theta is equals to tan inverse of 3 is the answer, students. So this is how we have to find the value of the, students. So I hope you understand the two problems here. Fine. Next, we will go for one more numerical. Write down, students. A stone is thrown horizontally. Write down. Make a note of it. A stone is thrown horizontally with the velocity g meter by second. So u is equals to g meter by second. It has given. You can see the problem from the top of the tower of height g meter. So height of the tower is given by g meter. So g meter. Fine. G meter. Fine. The velocity with what it will hit the ground. So what is the velocity when it is reaching the ground? So we know very well, students, v is nothing but at any time t is given by, what is that formula? U square plus g square t square. So in order to know the velocity value, we should know what is time of descent. What is the total time taken to reach the ground? So you know very well, what is the time of descent formula, students? So t is equals to square root of 2h by g, students. Now 2 into 2 only, h means what already we know? g itself by g. So gg cancel. Time is root 2 seconds. Any doubts in the time? Root 2 seconds, no doubt. Now we can use this formula right now, students. So v at any time t is given by u square plus g square t square, students. So u square in a sense already we know, g square plus g square t square means g square. T square means what? 2. So finally, what is 2g square? So root 2 whole square, students. Root 2 whole square. T is root 2. Root 2 whole square means it will become 2. Root 2 whole square means. So now 2g square plus g square, 3g square is the final answer. So now square root get cancelled. Final answer is root 3g meter by second is the final answer, students. So this is how we have to find the answer for this kind of question. Any doubt, students, here? Next, we will go for one more question. Make a note of it. Simple problems. Okay, write down, students. A body is thrown horizontally from the top of the tower. It reaches the ground after 4 seconds. So time of descent is equals to 4 seconds. So total time taken to reach the ground is 4 seconds. At an angle of theta, 45. Theta is equals to 45 degree. Okay, fine. 45 degree to the horizontal. The velocity of projection is dash. So theta is, once again, I read the question. A body thrown horizontally, listen here, a body thrown horizontally from the top of the tower, okay, it reaches the ground 4 seconds, okay, and at an angle of 45 degree, the velocity of projection is dash. Okay, very good. Velocity of projection they are asking, that's it. So u value they are asking. Fine, students, first of all, what we have to do here is 4 seconds, tan theta is equals to 45. Do you know what is the formula for tan theta? Tan theta is equals to Vy by Vx. It is nothing but Gt by u is equals to tan 45, isn't it? Tan 45. You just write down the formula, Gt by u. Fine. Then theta already given 45 degrees. So tan 45 is equals to GT by U. So tan 45 means 1. So 1 is equals to GT by U. Then U is equals to GT. So equation number 1. Yes or no? U is equal to GT. We have to find the U only. But what is the time here? So time already given 4 seconds. So U is equals to G means 10 into 4. That is totally 40 meter by second is the velocity of projection, students. This is how we have to find. Say in your question they are taking G value 9.8. So that's why they are taking different answer we are getting. You can check here. So U is equals to 9.8 into 4 you will be getting here. So that your answer will be different, students, as like how they have shown in the answer session. You can check it once. Make a note of this, students. Next, I'll go for one more problem. Make a note. Okay, fine. So next, so two cliffs are there, height. So 120 meter and the two buildings are there. Let me consider 100.4 meter are separated by the horizontal distance. Okay, this problem is important, students. First, one building is there here, cliffs are there here. This is of 120 meter. One more building is there here. Okay, one more building is there, that is of 100.4 meter. Okay, fine. Two buildings are there. Okay, fine. They are separated by the horizontal distance. Distance between them is 16 meters. Okay, fine. 16 meter. Am I right? 16 meter, yes. If the car has reached from the first cliff to another second, then what is the horizontal velocity should be? Suppose, let me consider there is a car here. Say it is horizontally given one velocity u for that. So such that the car exactly should land on this. It has to land on this. Then what could be the initial velocity it has to move? Very simple answer, students, try to get my point. So can you tell me what is the vertical displacement moved by the car? That displacement is nothing but 120 minus. So this distance you have to find. First you find this distance, vertical distance moved by the car. So 120. So what is that? 120 meter minus 100.4 meter. Can you reduce this? Subtraction H2 minus H1. So write down this. What happens to this? 0, 6, 9. So what happened here? So it is 1. That's it. So 19.6 meter. So 19.6 meter is the distance, vertical displacement covered by the car. Vertical displacement. Do you know what is horizontal displacement covered by the car? That is this. You know the formula very well, students. Try to catch my point. Range in a sense 16 meter. Here also range in a sense 16 meter. Try to catch my point. It has to cover 16 meter. So range is equals to initial velocity into 2h by g. Did you remember this formula? Already we know this formula. Substitute them directly, you will be getting the answer. Write down. R is equals to, you know that is 16 meter. 16 is equals to, and coming to u, we don't know. And 2h by g, 2 into h means what? 19.6. So you can take 19.6 here, but g means 9.8. So 9.8, 1 j, 9.8, 2 z, 2 into 2, 4. So here root 2 is there, no? So 2u. 2u is equal to 16. U is equals to 8 meter by second, students. Did you understand how I got this? So here under root is there. 2 into 2 means 2 will be the answer. 2 into 2, 4. 4 under root means 2. So 2u. This is not 24, students. 2u. 2u is equal to 16. U is equal to 8 meter by second is the answer. I hope you understand. Next problem we will do. Make a note of this, students. Okay, what would be the next problem? See here, an aeroplane is flying horizontally at an altitude of 490 meters. So h is equals to 490 meters, students. Next we'll go for with a speed of 18 kmph. So u is equals to 180 kmph. And coming to the next point, what they have given a and drops a bomb, the horizontal distance at which it will hit the ground. So range they are asking us to find. Fine, students. So how to do this kind of problem? Let us consider this KMPH. You have to convert in meter by second. How can you convert 180 into 5 by 18, students? 18 ones are 18 tens are. So answer is 50 meter by second is the velocity. So you can write here. Sorry, students. U is equals to 50 meter by second is the velocity here. So once you know U value, then range they are asking. What is the formula for range? Already I told you, U into 2h by g. So based on the situation, you have to use the formula, students. U in a sense 50, 2 into h in a sense 490, divided by g means 9.8. That's it. Simple. So how can you do this? So 9.8. So 49 0.20. So this 2 will come upside, then it will become 20. This 2 will come upside, this will become 50. 50 into 2. Try to catch my point. 50 into this 0.2 will come upside, it will become 5, right? 1 by 5. So it will become 50. 50 into 200. So like this you will be getting. 100 means 10. 10 into this 500 meter is the horizontal range for this problem. I hope you understand, students. Shall we go for the next problem? Make a note of this. Take a screenshot, students. If you have any doubt, you can post in the comment section. Definitely I will help you on this. Next problem, write down this. A ball is thrown horizontally with a velocity v. So horizontal velocity v. Okay, a ball is thrown v at the top of the tower of height h. Height of the tower is h. Okay, what they are asking? The top of the tower height h. It reaches the ground at time t. So time taken is equals to t to reach the ground. Okay, another ball of double mass is thrown horizontally with a 3v velocity. This is about first ball. This is about ball 1. Let me go for the second ball, ball 2. So velocity, 3v velocity it has started. Okay, 3v velocity from the top of another tower. Okay, of height 4h. So h2 is equals to 4h here. This tower height is 4h. Okay, it reaches the ground at what time? So t2 is equals to dash they are asking. That's it. So how can you do this sum actually? So first they are asking time. So in order to find the time, how can you do the time? Listen here carefully, students. So first of all, what is the formula we supposed to take? T is equals to, write it now. T is equals to 2h by g is the formula we have to take here. See guys, here in this problem same acceleration due to gravity we need to apply. Okay, fine. T is equal to 2h by g. Okay, fine. So let us suppose take this formula. It is nothing but, what is that? 2h by g is the t value. Remember, this is equation number 1. Let me consider t2 value. T2, how can you find here? T2 in a sense, how can you find, students? So 2 into h means what? 4h here by g. Okay, it is not depending upon velocity. So g we have to write here downside. So now what to do here? 2 is there here, 2h by g, we know t. So send this 4 outside. Then what happens to the 4? It will become 2. So 2 into 2h by g you can write. We know already the value of 2h by g is t. So now t into 2 into t we can write. So 2 t2 is equals to, for the second t2 is equals to 2 into t. 2t is the answer for this. I hope you understand how clearly it is given. See here. So 2t is the answer for the question already, because 2h by g already it has given t. But one thing you should understand, this time of descent or time of flight, it doesn't depends upon velocity. So whatever the velocity it may be, it doesn't depends upon the horizontal velocity, students. It always depends upon the h value. That's why we have done the problem like this. Very simple problem. Okay, shall we go for the next problem? Make a note of this, students. Okay, coming to the next point. In the above, next point, write down. A ball is projected horizontally from the top of a building of height given 19.6 meter height as given, students. Okay, and if the line joining of the projection and the point where it is hits the ground, then the angle is 45 degrees to the horizontal. So line joining theta is equals to 45 degrees. I will let you know the diagram. 45 degrees, okay, to the horizontal. The initial velocity of the ball is dash. Initial velocity of the ball is dash. That is the question. See students, first of all you have to draw the diagram. Definitely diagram is needed for this question. Let us consider our horizontal range is R here. The ball is started moving from here. Initial velocity u. So unfortunately the ball definitely it will go in a parabolic path, you know these whole things, okay, fine. But what they are asking here is, what is an angle 45 here? Once again you can see that 45 degrees students, okay. If the line joining of the point of projection and point where it is reached, you should draw the line here, it will make 45 degrees, they said clearly, with the x axis it is making 45 degrees. So if it is making 45 degrees, this is R, this is H, you know very well. But they are asking U value. Very simple, simplest answer. You know R is equals to U into square root of 2H by G. This formula you know. You know this and this. Okay, fine. Very simple, you can say one thing. Tan theta is equals to opposite side by adjacent side. Opposite side is H, adjacent side is R. So H by R. Any doubts here? H means H itself. R means what? U into 2H by G. It is nothing but tan 45. Tan 45 means 1. So you can do cross multiplication now. Students, you can do cross multiplication here. What you will get? Actually, this denominator will be equal to numerator. So now U into 2 square root of 2H by G is equals to H. Okay. So here square root of H is there, here square root of H will be get cancelled, here square root of H will come. So U into 2 by okay G is equals to root H. This is the final answer. Now send this all that side, then what happens to U? U is equals to, so this entire thing will be divided here. Divided here means it will become reverse. So 2G, GH, lie down. dH by 2 you will be getting. So h value already we know, substitute here. Students will make a note of it. H value already you know, substitute here. U is equals to g means what? 9.8, and 9.8 you can take, no problem. 9.8, and h means what? 19.6 divided by 2 under root.